Hey there guys, welcome back to another video. Now today, holy crap guys, one of my stocks just went up like 1000%. Holy crap guys, I think we've hit the jackpot guys. We just became rich. Yes. Okay, now the stock that I invested in is actually okay, what's going on? I had 10 shares of this stock but I only have one. That doesn't make sense. But it went up like 1000%. Don't when stocks go up a certain percentage, aren't they supposed to make you a lot of money? But why did they reduce the amount of shares that I actually own right now? Huh, that's weird. Am I going crazy or something? What's going on? Okay, that's really confusing. I might have to go do some research on this real quick, guys, okay? Let me get back to you on that real quick. Okay, guys, so I just did some research on this, and apparently what's actually happened, well, for one, I'm not rich. That sucks. We didn't hit the jackpot. We didn't hit that one lucky stock. What did happen instead is what's called a stock reverse split, or also known as a share rollback. So I guess I'm gonna have to go over on what a reverse stock split is, okay guys? Because you don't wanna be like me guys, just like in the beginning of the video, thinking I just hit a huge big jackpot on the stock when essentially I didn't. In fact, this might be even a worse thing than what I assumed. But anyways guys, how are you guys doing today? I hope you guys are having a fabulous weekend. I hope you enjoyed that little scenario in the beginning of the video. And if you did, be sure to give it a like. Now, if you watched my last video, I basically went over on what a stock split is. So it's only natural that I go over on what a reverse stock split is. So if you don't know what a reverse stock split is, well, it's essentially the opposite of what a stock split is. Now, we all know what a stock split is, okay? Hopefully we do. If not, then I'll definitely link that video down in the description down below or somewhere in the comments. So be sure to check that video out before you even watch this one so you'll know the difference already before you watch it. So again, if you watch that video, then you'll know that a stock split is basically when a company decides to split their stock, meaning if they have 10 shares and they do a 1-for-2 or something like that stock split, then essentially those 10 shares will multiply into 20 shares because it's a 1-for-2, meaning they'll split it from 1 to 2 for each share. So again guys, 10 shares, they're splitting it into 2 each one. 10 times 2 is 20. So a reverse stock split is basically going to be when a corporation decides to actually reduce the number of outstanding shares that they currently own. So take for example, let's say a corporation has, I don't know, 10 shares. I know that's very low, but just for an example. Now, let's say they have only 10 shares, but they want to reduce those shares into a, maybe let's say 10-for-1. So basically what it means is that it's going to reduce every 10 shares into 1. So if it had maybe, I don't know, 100 shares, then for every 10, it'll reduce it to 1. So instead of having 100 shares, it's going to have 10 shares because 100 divided by 10 is 10. So they basically reduce the amount of outstanding shares that they currently own. Now do also keep in mind that this also doesn't change their market capitalization just like a normal stock split is, okay? It doesn't change none of that. It just changes the amount of shares that they currently own. So when you own some of these stocks, let's say you own, I don't know, maybe 1,000 or something. Now those 1,000, depending on what type of split they actually do, it'll reduce to fewer amounts. So instead of owning 1,000 shares, you're probably gonna owe maybe 100 or, I don't know, 200 or something like that. It just depends. It could be a 5-for-1, it could be a 10-for-1, it could be a 20-for-1. It just really depends on how the corporation does it. So they basically do a reverse stock split because they see their stock price as too low. And this also means that they're in risk of being delisted. So if they're in risk of being delisted because their stock price is a little too low, then that's when they do a reverse stock split to make, you know, the price increase. Because take for example, if a stock is maybe, I don't know, 50 cents a share and you own like 10,000 shares of these stocks and they go with the reverse stock split, those 10,000 shares, once they're reduced, I mean, it could go from 50 cents a share to maybe $5 a share or $10 a share or anything like that. So essentially that makes the stock prices inflated, if you know what I mean. Now they will also notify shareholders about a reverse stock split in order to vote for this. So if you own some of those shares, you'll have a chance to vote through maybe through email or something like that. And then they'll proceed with that. And also this gives you a little heads up on knowing if they actually do, so that you can be better prepared on what to do with your portfolio at the moment at the same time. Now don't assume just because that your stock price has increased tremendously that it's a good thing. If anything, unlike a stock split, you know, a normal stock split, where everybody wants to actually be buying those type of shares, A reverse stock split is going to be the opposite of that, because this will usually spark off a sell-off, meaning that once a reverse stock split usually happens, people are going to be selling off those shares. And when they sell off those shares, they're going to be driving the price even more down. So now that's when the market capitalization will actually change, guys, okay? Because they have less money to deal with. They have less money to, you know, invest into their companies to grow and everything. Now, again, a reverse stock split is usually a bad thing. So if this sounds like a bad thing, why would a company actually do it, you might ask yourself? Well, again, the biggest factor is going to be listing requirements, okay, guys? Because a stock exchange typically requires a minimum bid price for a stock to be listed, meaning you have to have the stock price at a certain price to be, I don't know, into the New York Stock Exchange or the NASDAQ or anything like that. So if you don't have it at a certain price, then you're going to risk being delisted. Therefore, you're going to be considered a penny stock, and you don't want that happening to your company, because more investors will see your company as a risk type of company, and then they won't want to invest with you guys, which means that company will also have less capital to, you know, build their companies over, just like I mentioned earlier. Now, another reason is that it deters short selling, meaning it makes it harder for people to borrow shares, therefore making it harder for other people to, you know, make some quick money off them like that. Because when you increase the price of your shares, it makes it harder, you know, to basically borrow more money to buy those shares, since they're more, I guess, expensive. Oh, so you're telling me that I didn't get rich then, right? No, sadly you didn't, okay? It just means the company might be going through a bad time, and I would highly suggest readjusting your portfolio, maybe. Okay, so I guess I didn't get rich, guys. I guess we didn't, you know, hit the jackpot or anything. I might have to reconsider my portfolio, just like he said. Now, sometimes a reverse stock split doesn't have to be bad all the time. It can actually be a good thing, but most of the times it's just a bad thing. And I would probably stay away from most companies that do a reverse stock split, because most people have only seen the bad side of a reverse stock split, okay, guys? But anyways, guys, that's gonna wrap it up for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to give it a like. And as always, leave me a comment down below. Let me know what you guys think. And also, guys, be sure to check out the links down below where you can follow me on Instagram and Snapchat, so that way you can keep in contact with me in case you have any questions, or I don't know, maybe you just want to follow me, you know? But anyways, guys, that's gonna wrap it up. Also, be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, okay, guys? Be sure to hit that little notification bell at the same time so you stay in tune with more videos and you stay updated. So anyways, guys, I'm gonna wrap it up. I'm gonna let you go, and I'll see you guys on the next video.